Hello everyone, Christian here. Did you know in the US alone, you need to ensure that you're properly collecting taxes across 46 states and 11,000 different jurisdictions? And if you don't, you have to pass go and go directly to prison. Okay, that last bit was a little bit extreme, but let's talk about the super sexy topic of taxes. US sales tax is very complex and it can be discouraging for a lot of you folks out there. Now, Shopify in the recent months have overhauled their tax features to make things a little bit smoother for merchants. And you might have already seen a little bit of this, but now they're actually giving it a proper name and it's called Shopify Tax. So what is Shopify Tax? So Shopify Tax puts sales tax insights and collection in your control and makes everything manageable from your Shopify admin. So at a glance, you'll know when you're liable with a state-by-state overview. It also reveals where you're approaching a tax threshold, so allowing your business to actually prepare for the taxes that are gonna be coming. With Shopify Tax, you can also apply the right taxes at the right time with calculations based on the buyer's precise address. This is also known as rooftop accuracy. Shopify takes care of all of this in the background, so you don't have to do a whole lot of things. Now, they also make sure to collect the right taxes for the right products. So adding product categories is going to be an absolutely crucial part of the process of adding new products to your store. And we'll talk a little bit more about this here in a second. Now, before we move on, I just want to say bienvenidos. My name is Christian Piñon, one of the co-founders here at BitBrand. We're an e-commerce growth agency that specializes in helping clothing stores grow and scale profitably online. We drop new videos every week, so make sure that you hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications so you don't miss out. Now let's talk about pricing. Nothing in life is free, right? So Shopify Tax is going to be a new service that automatically gets added to your store and you cannot really turn it off. Now, for the rest of 2022, you won't have to pay anything extra besides of what you're currently paying right now for your Shopify subscription. It is going to be free forever for the first $100,000 in US sales each calendar year. After the $100,000, a 0.35% fee or 0.25% fee for plus merchants will apply for subsequent orders that calculate sales tax in the US alone. Also, as a promotion for the next year, 2023, the total annual Shopify tax costs will be capped at $5,000. Now, the only bad part is that this is just for Shopify Plus stores. So anyone below, there won't be a cap for next year. Now, another question that you might be asking is, what about outside the US? Well, Shopify Tax is built right now exclusively to manage your US sales tax obligations. Hopefully in the future, they will manage international and global taxes, but right now it just seems like they're really harping on focusing on US sales tax obligations. I believe from what I've read that they want to become a very all-encompassing platform, so adding taxes globally and managing that will probably be something that they add sometime in the future. Probably not anytime close, but sometime in the future. Now, managing numbers and data and all this stuff can be very cumbersome. Now, I want to let you in a little secret. It's not tax related, but it's all analytics and metrics related, right? We're using a tool called Triple Well for all of our client and group coaching members. And this tool allows us to see the lifetime value of a customer at 30, 60, 90 days. But we're also very excited about the estimated action of customers. So it's just a slight little feature in there. So imagine being able to send out email campaigns or ad campaigns to customers who are actually likely to buy from you a second or third time and knowing when to exactly send out these marketing messages. Triple Well is super, super powerful. It centralizes all of your metrics all into one place. They simplify, inform, and save you time. So make sure to check out the link in the description below. There is a slight little discount code in there for you if you want to just try out Triple Well for the first time. Now, we talked about a little bit of product categorization. It's going to be very important moving forward. So let's talk about product categorization. So is a hot dog a sandwich? As a society, we may never agree on the answer. I believe Aaron is in the camp of it's a sandwich. I don't think it's a sandwich. What do you think? Let us know down in the comments below if a hot dog is a sandwich. At Shopify, they can help you categorize your hot dog for tax purposes at least. So they may not have that answer, but they'll be able to help you categorize that. So for example, if you live in New York, you may find that you pay a tax when you buy a hot dog from a local stand, but not when you buy a pack when you're doing your neighborhood barbecue. So in each state, different rules of the amount of tax that needs to be charge will be different on a per product basis, right? Or what you use the product for. So that's where smart categorization comes in. And this new feature helps you figure out these rules when you add new products to your store. And really the smart categorization based on the titles and the description of the actual product that you're putting in, Shopify will automatically recommend you a product category. So once you approve or modify, then it will automatically assign a proper tax rate based on local regulations. So if you're adding shoes and you're typing in the product title that this is a Nike, Air Force, whatever, and the description it talks about being a shoe, then the product category, you will see that it will showcase it's a shoe, right? And you just, all you have to do is just approve it or potentially modify it, right? Depending on your store and what you have currently in. If you like what you see, please consider clicking on that like button. It really helps us out a lot. One of my YouTube videos without an actual screen recording, right? So let's jump in and kind of show you around a little bit of the tax and duties section. So right now, if you go to your settings and then you go to taxes and duties, you will see this brand new banner in here. It'll say stay compliant in the US with Shopify Tax. And you might also see some notices in here. So this one says you're not charging taxes on some product variants. And this one says you may have sales tax liability in four different states. So all these things you need to make sure that you're checking inside of your admin settings, taxes and duties. I'm gonna click on review US tax settings here for the new Shopify Tax. And in here you'll see like there's manage tax collection, tax rate exemptions, reporting, manage your tax collection. It will actually give you, like I said, a state-by-state breakdown of where you're actually liable for taxes. We'll blur some of these things in here so you don't know that. And then categorize your products for tax purposes. So in here you see we have 1,400 products that we need to review for this store. So again, it's a time-consuming process, and you have towards the end of this year really to kind of figure all these things out because it will start 2023. So it's very important that you have all these things figured out. Now, when you manage categories here for the products, you'll see right within here, it will actually show you the products and it will give you the product category. So very quickly, you can actually at a glance change things around. And like I said, obviously there's a smart categorization. So it will automatically tell you what it thinks that product is. All you have to do is just approve, deny, or modify. All right, so there you have it, Shopify Tax. They're actually making it a lot simpler for you to manage your taxes for US sales. We highly, highly encourage you to start exploring with Shopify Tax features, start categorizing your products, and getting a better understanding of your current and upcoming liabilities. All right, see you on the next one.